After a long election, clearly there's some tension between all parties here. But what took place in a house was crazier than anything I've seen in my 35 years as a referee. You can see things start innocuously enough as conservative whip Gord Brown is trying to get through the neutral zone, but is obstructed by a wall of NDP members. That should be 2 minutes for interference on the NDP. The refs clearly missed that. But things escalated quickly after Justin Trudeau, the captain of the Liberals, steps on the ice. Trudeau skated through the blockade to assist and at first makes a legal hip check on NDP MP Ruth Ellen Brousseau. But then Trudeau has secondary contact with the elbow. You can't blame the refs for missing the call in the house. It was a bang-bang play. But when you look at the instant replay in slow-mo, that's a minor penalty. Elbow right to the chest. Accidental or not, Mr. Prime Minister, you have to be in control of your body at all times. While struck to some degree, I'd say Ms. Brousseau embellished the contact and should have been assessed 2 minutes for diving as well. Now, just when you think the play is dead and Brousseau goes off to the locker room for repairs, that's when Trudeau steps back onto the ice. Here is where NDP leader Tom Mulcair leaves his players' bench for the purpose of starting an altercation. Right there, Mr. Mulcair should get 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct and a game misconduct under Rule 70.6. On top of that, Mulcair should automatically be hit by the league with a 10-game suspension without pay under Rule 70.10. Now you can see the referees here don't step in early enough. There's a bit of chirping from the NDP bench. Nothing wrong with that in my books. But then on the left side, Environment and Climate Change Minister Catherine McKenna is the second player to illegally leave the players' bench during an altercation. And that's when the bench is clear. By rule, McKenna should be automatically suspended without pay for the next 5 games. Cooler heads did prevail in some parts of the house. In the background here, you can see Stephen Harper, the former GM of the Conservative Party, steering clear from the whole debacle. It seems in his new advisory role for the team, he has no inkling to get involved.
Order! Order!
So let's tally up the infractions between the interference, elbowing, and unsportsmanlike conduct penalties. The Liberals and the NDP should be shorthanded for the next little while. And I wouldn't be surprised to see some supplementary discipline in the way of suspensions in the coming days. Since a clearing of both benches ensued, pending a review by the acting commissioner, I think both coaches for the NDP and Liberal teams should be slapped with a maximum fine of $10,000. Come on, ref!